We'll be going over how to set up Resolume effects to react to audio. I'll be using Arena 4, but this also applies to Avenue since the interface is essentially the same. So you've got three choices for your source audio. First is composition. And if you have an audio clip loaded into one of your comps, you can just play that back and use that as a source. Next would be clip. If your clip has audio and it's native to the clip, you can use that as well. And last is external FFT, which is basically an external source. And this is what I'll be focusing on since it's what you'd most likely be working with at a gig or a show. So let's go ahead and set up your external source. If you go to Preferences, click on the Audio tab, and go down here to External FFT Input. I've got audio coming into a USB interface, but if you don't have a direct line in at an event, you could also use a mic. Depending on how loud or soft your input is, you could also adjust this input gain to boost or reduce the levels coming in. So now let's set up effects to react to an audio source. I'll choose Shape Aeration from the polyphonic set on our website. I'll be using two effects for this visual that I feel are complementary to it. The first being distortion. And if you scroll down further, the second is ripples. Next, you choose the parameter of the effect you'd like to make audio reactive. For distort, I want to adjust the distort level. So I'll adjust the radius down a bit so that it has a stronger effect. That looks pretty good. For ripples, I want to go for this bulging effect. So if you adjust the amplitude V, and you can center it by adjusting the phase, and that has the effect that I'm looking for. Now we'll make these effects audio reactive. I'll go ahead and play this audio track so you can see and hear what's going on. If you hover above the name of the parameter you're making audio reactive, you can click on an arrow here and choose your external source. Click on the arrow next to the gain knob here, and you'll see your audio waveform in real time. You can choose low, mid, and high frequencies with these buttons here to drive your parameter, or you can use the slider to dial in precisely what part of the audio you want to drive the parameter with. I want distortion to react to that snare sound, so I'll drag the sliders to the general area. You'll want to adjust the gain until it affects the chosen parameter to your liking. I'll bring it up a bit because when I hear that snare sound, I want it to peak on the value of the parameter. Alright, that's looking pretty good. Next to gain is this fall knob. By setting this high, you get a really twitchy or snappy effect. And if you set it low, it becomes a much smoother transition. Next, I'll talk about the buttons by the waveform here. And this back button makes a parameter react from the highest value to the lowest. So you can see that it's already at its peak and it's moving backwards. The forward button is the default, lowest to highest. And we have the minus, which cycles the effect backwards. And it moves faster depending on how much of the frequency is triggered. And the last button is the plus button. And this cycles the parameter value forward. And it moves across values from lowest to highest depending on how much of the frequency is triggered. So if you click on the small arrow next to the parameter name, you can adjust the easing. And what that does is it helps smooth out the motion of the audio reaction. It also reduces stuttering. So if you look here, it's actually pretty smooth now. So now I'll make the ripples effect audio reactive. So I'll adjust amplitude V and I'll go into audio FFT external. I want to isolate the kick drum, so I'll focus on the lower frequencies here. So the song's about to loop again, but I'll go ahead and make these adjustments now so that when the beat comes back, it should hit on the low frequency kick drum. If you find that your waveform isn't really showing up well, you can also adjust the input gain in preferences, and that should help it out. So I'm going to go and adjust the easing of this parameter just to smooth things out. And it's looking pretty good. Everything seems to be hitting on beat. I like making my visuals look different with effects, so I'm gonna enable this dot effect here and shift RGB just to add a little extra style to it. And that's looking pretty good. So I like to layer things as well, so I'm gonna add this speaker dots visual, and this is from the sound supply set, and I'll trigger that. I also made the opacity audio reactive, and I added some color grading using the hue rotate effect just to match the other visual as well. And these were just presets that I set up. So I'll share a couple tips with you. Use the sliders to really dial in on the frequency of the sound you want. So if you're looking for that snare or that kick drum, play with the slider until you isolate that certain sound, because the effect is more pronounced than choosing a larger range. If you want to make an effect audio reactive quickly, use the low, mid, and high frequency buttons, especially in live situations where you just need a quick setup. These are really handy. If you find a good combination of effects, I highly recommend making presets. It's a good way to have multiple versions of the same clip with different effects and different looks. And my last tip is experiment. There's so many different parameters and effects you can play with, and making your visuals more audio reactive definitely engages your audience much better. And that's all it takes. Hopefully this was helpful and it makes your visuals much more compelling. Check us out at docoptic.com if you're looking for some live visual content, training, tutorials, and even some example visual mixes. And thank you for watching.